Hello and welcome. I'm glad you are here. Our videos are informative and entertaining. They have an excellent chance to cheer you up while providing helpful information. If you are here just for Apache ECharts, please use the timestamp from the description box below to jump into the corresponding chapter. If you are up for a high-level refresher about the basic Grafana concepts, please keep watching. Let's go! Grafana was created more than 7 years ago for IT systems monitoring and observability. The lightweight, transparent architecture made Grafana easy to use and adapt for various use cases. Laconically put, Grafana has three parts. Data source translates data into Grafana format. Visualization creates a graphical representation of your choice based on that data. And Grafana platform is responsible for authentication, authorization, and system layer to work on any operating system. But most importantly, Grafana platform is designed to combine a variety of data sources with any number of visualizations. Grafana permits data refreshing as often as 500 milliseconds, works in no internet environment, and doesn't copy your data anywhere. Instead, it creates graphs on the fly. There are a lot of built-in data sources and visualizations, meaning you get them with the Grafana app. Some of them you would need to install from the Grafana marketplace, which is literally as quick and easy as selecting a plugin from the menu and clicking on it. Boom! The Base64 plugin has been installed. With all that glory, however, people noticed two major pain points with Grafana. The first one is the lack of documentation. The other pain point is the lack of modern touch in the visualization panels. And now is an excellent time to introduce ECharts. Apache ECharts is an open source JavaScript visualization library. In January last year, the Apache Software Foundation announced Apache ECharts as a top-level project. The project originated in 2013 at Baidu, which is Chinese Google, and entered the Apache incubator in January of 2018. Well-known Apache Superset is transitioning to using Apache ECharts as its main charting library. Here is what you would see if you open echarts.apache.org. I click Demo and scroll down in awe of more than 30 different charts categories with many options in each. The variety includes almost all charts ever invented for the data visualization, from basic line and bar charts to tree nodes, sunburst, theme river, and complex 3D graphs. They even have dynamic race charts and symbol shape morphs. Many charts support drill down functionality without any extra work. Also, all charts have an emphasis option. It is when a chart's element gets highlighted when a mouse cursor hovers over. What fascinated me the most about Apache eChart is its excellent documentation with pieces of code ready to copy and paste into their interactive demos. Let me show you what I mean. I go to the same echarts.apache.org website and click the Get Started button. Then open, let's say, a waterfall bar chart. If I want to try it out, I just need to copy that code, go to the demo part, open any chart, and pass that code in the left side. Here you go. The code is working on the right side. Nice and easy, and honestly, very satisfying. I can keep my experiments right here to get a better idea of how the graph works. Let's say I like this stacked horizontal bar graph, but I need it to be in the colors of my brand. I specify the colors per my requirements and enjoy the changes as I make them. Now let's see how to use ECharts in Grafana. Step 1. Install Apache ECharts panel. You can find the latest information about this panel on our website. ECharts panel is under review to be added to Grafana Marketplace. Until then, you can install it manually from our private repository or download it directly from the GitHub repository using the following command. After the command is run, restart your Grafana. Step 2. Choose the eChart panel from the drop-down. Step 3. Go to the eChart website and copy the code from the visualization of your choice. Let's say I'm interested in the gradient stacked area chart. Step 4. Insert the code into this part. It is a Monaco code editor, well known from the Visual Studio Code. ECHART Grafana panel brings it to you with all blows and whistles, like basic syntax colorization, context help, and highlighting the places with syntax errors. Step 5. Adapt the code. For a basic adaption, only one change is required. You need to replace options with return. That's it. Step 6. Using the data from your data source. Right above the Monaco code editor window, you can notice the following hint: available parameters, data, theme, eChart instance, eCharts. It means that Grafana populates those four parameters and passes them into the eChart set option function. The data parameter is where the data from the data source renders. Let's say I want to redo the bar chart with sales per month from a dashboard I created in one of my videos in the past. How would I do that? I open the bar chart I find suitable, copy the code, and change the options to return. Ensure the data source is my Postgres database and insert the SQL query to fetch the data. The query returns two columns, namely months and total underscore sales. The eCharts requires data to be in arrays. If you look at some eChart examples, you would see something like this. So this is what I'm going to do. I will declare two arrays like this and then populate them with values from the data source using the following code. Note where I use the column names in this code. The last modification is to specify data for x-axis and y-axis. Did it work? Now I will quickly make more changes to display sales in a currency format, change colors, and make a selected bar transparent. Save, apply. Let's look at two charts side by side. One is from Grafana, another one from eCharts. The one obvious difference that jumps at you is animation. The eChart looks alive. The other difference that is not that obvious, that you can download any eChart as a picture. Here I have a PNG file. The toolbox feature needs to be specified to enable the download option. The last panel I would like to redo in this video is a clock panel. Here is what it looks like on my first Grafana dashboard. Here is what the basic eChart clock panel looks like. And here's what I made of it. You might wonder how I place my company's logo on the panel. Here is how. First of all, I have my company's logo in SVG format. Open the SVG file in a text editor. Find the parts with coordinates, copy them, and then place them into your panel. You might need to adjust the size parameter. That's it. I hope you learned something helpful today. Apache eCharts is a mighty tool. You don't need a senior JavaScript developer to start displaying some basic modern-looking animated visualizations. And if your use case is unique, then Apache eCharts provide an excellent venue to develop visualizations of any complexity. The eChart panel for Grafana is a bridge that has been missing and has finally arrived. You can use the benefits of two great open-source products, Grafana and Apache eCharts, in one solution tailored for your needs. Our demo server has some examples. Feel free to use the code from there for your experiments. That's all what I have for today. Thanks for watching. Bye for now and see you next time.